What's going on, everyone? I'm Greg with RC Driver, and take a look at this beast. Man, when this thing arrived, I just had to rip open the box and check it out. So we're not gonna do the usual, let me show you everything that comes with the unboxing type of video that I normally do. I just wanna dive right into the features of the Losi Super Rock Rey. This thing is so cool. This is basically, you know, like a rock racer. It is a rock racer. And, you know, Losi really went the extra mile on this, I think. There are just so many cool details. And no matter where you look, you're like finding something else that they did on this. And where should I start? Let's start off with the body. They do have licensed graphics for these bodies. This is the Raceline version. And there is the Baja Designs version of it. But I really like this one. Graphics on it are just so cool. And the body panels are actually held on with screws and large body washers and stuff. That is pretty neat. I've already taken that off because I'm going to show you what's underneath the body shell. But the body shell itself is Lexan, so it's got some flex to it and stuff. We've got this cool roof panel here. Just a really, really neat looking rock buggy. Now let's move on to the LED lights, because that really stood out to me. And there are actually a lot of LED lights on here. So we got the light bar up top, we've got the light bar in the front bumper, and there's actually a light bar in the back. So, you know, if you're driving at night, you know where the front is and where the rear of the vehicle is. That is super cool. You know, they look like they're going to be really bright. They've got these Lexan covers on them. And the thing is, with this one, it's kind of bowing out a little bit. So I'm going to have to fix that. But definitely like the look of light bars. And I don't have to add those on or even wire it. So that is a bonus. Now let's talk about the Fox shock, or I should say faux reservoirs that are on here. So we've got some big shocks I'm going to talk to you guys about. But, you know, they've got these little rubber tubes that come off into the reservoirs, both front and rear. And it gives it that licensed, you know, Fox shock look to it. That is pretty neat. And then we've got some fire extinguishers on the sides. And again, that adds even more to the scale of this, including the window nets. I think that is very cool. And they are rubber, so they kind of just flex and will probably flop around like the real buggy does when it's driving. And then, of course, we've got the, like an interior setup in here. Driver's heads look like they are molded separately. And then the bodies and the rest of the interior is molded from Lexan. But we got some decal work and stuff going on there. That looks pretty neat. I see a big speed controller sitting in there that I want to talk to you guys about in a little bit. But very cool details on the outside of it. I should probably also talk about the Maxxis Creeper tire as well. You know, this thing is sitting here. So, you know, these are licensed tires. They're pretty firm. And I imagine they have to be because this thing is going to run on 8S. At least I'm going to run it on 8S. I might start off with 6S and then work my way up. But I definitely have 8S worth of LiPo to stick in this thing, and I'm going to look forward to that. There's even a spare on the back. And yes, this is a full-size working spare. You blow one of these tires out, you can put this tire on. It's got a little wing nut in the back. You can just unscrew that. These rims look very cool. They've got the red B-lock ring. It's just a painted ring, but, you know, it's got the look to it. And of course, the hex on here is a 17 millimeter. You use a 17 millimeter wheel wrench to take the wheels off. And I've already had the wheels off, and I had to use my Craftsman 17 millimeter socket with a ratchet to get them off, because they were on there really, really tight. Let me see, am I missing anything here? We got some mirrors on the side and, you know, the full cage work in here. Just super cool look to it. You know, I'm on the East Coast. We don't have a lot of rock racers around here, at least that I know of. So when something like this rolls across my desk, I really get into it. I really like the look of this. All right, I am going to go take this body panel off, and then I'll be able to talk to you about some more of the features on the inside. All right, so I've gone ahead here and taken off all the body panels, basically the center panel and then the top roof panel. And as I mentioned before, everything is held on with screws and body washers. So I really recommend having an electric power driver to work on this vehicle, because just taking the body off, your hand would go tired taking all the screws off. Also, I had to take off the rear wheel. It was just a wing nut on the back. And I had to take the mirrors off to slide the body off. So that's what you need to do just to get to the inside of this beast. So now that you can see it, let's start to talk about the front of the vehicle. And it's got this really cool skid bumper up front. As I mentioned, it's already got the LED light bar built into it. And then it has this really cool bracing behind it, so it looks like a really strong front bumper. And then what really catches my eye next are these tubular like shock towers for the front. It just has a realistic look to it, and the composite on here looks really, really nice. Looks like it's really sturdy, and I might as well get right into the suspension and talk about these shocks. Aluminum bodied shocks, aluminum cap, aluminum lower cap, really thick shock shaft on here. Got bump stops on the bottom, really aggressive looking springs, and then the threaded body so you could adjust the collar and adjust the preload on here. Really long travel shock, and you know what? It feels really, really awesome. I like the feel of it. All right, now down to the suspension arms themselves. We've got a dual wishbone setup. The lower arm is just a flat plate looking arm, so there's no kind of ridges on the bottom or anything like that, just a flat plate. But it does have a upper top cap to the arm, so I'm assuming that inside is hollow, so it lightens the arm a little bit, and then they put that top cap on there, kind of like a racing suspension arm. To cover things up. So pretty neat look there. And there is a couple of holes on the bottom, so you can move the shock out for a little bit of tuning there. The upper A arm does have a turnbuckle on there, pretty solid looking turnbuckle. And of course you can adjust the camber of the suspension with an adjustable turnbuckle. The arms go out to solid looking caster blocks that support a really robust looking steering knuckle. And what I like about this steering knuckle is on the end of it is basically a brake caliper, and that kind of mates up with a brake disc just for scale looks. The brake disc kind of just spins on the axle, and but all together looks super cool. I really like the look of it. And you know, on the outside, as I mentioned earlier, is a 17 millimeter wheel hex, so you know what type of wheels to get for this if you want to try something aftermarket on it. But the wheels on here, again, very cool look to them. Can't wait to see how they do outside on the terrain. Now let's just talk about the suspension pins, because they are really sticking out at me. We've got a really robust U-shaped pin on the top. On the bottom, there are aluminum plates to help brace up the suspension. So if you're, you know, tumbling this thing, those aluminum plates prevent the pins from ripping out of the bulkhead or the arm. So hopefully everything works out there. Let's talk about the drivetrain now. There is a gear differential in the front here. All metal gears, has to be all metal gears. This thing is 8S, so has to have metal gears in there. And what's really, really neat is it is oil filled, so you could go and tune it if you want to. It'd be a lot of work taking this thing apart, but that option is there. The differential sends power to these plastic telescoping drive shafts. They do have metal ends on them, which is pretty cool. And again, the plastic on here looks like it's a really strong, durable plastic, so hopefully everything holds up there. All right, now let me talk to you about the steering, and what really just jumps out is the size of these steering tie rods. Holy cow, those things are huge. They've got captured rod ends on it, which is great to see. So when you're bashing, hopefully those things don't pop off. But the steering links go to a dual bell crank steering setup. It's got a servo saver built into it. It has to. I mean, the weight of this thing tumbling around, it's going to cause some stress on the servo. They do have a large scale servo in here, a Spectrum servo, the S940. And there is a metal arm on that for, you know, durability. So everything, again, durability everywhere. And what even screams more durability is a 4 millimeter thick anodized aluminum chassis with a 4 millimeter thick upper deck. Anything over 3 millimeter is cool in my book. So nice to see the size of the chassis plate thickness on here. And let me flip it over, show you guys the lower chassis plate. So here it is. You can see it's kind of a stamp plate. It's got this little bulge in the bottom. And then all the screw holes are countersunk, so it's not going to hang up on anything. And this is what I really like over here, is this aluminum battery door. Yeah, they could have went with plastic, but no, the battery door too is aluminum. It's got this cool little pull tab back here. You pull back on that and you just pull the door open. You can access the battery tunnel. You put two 3S packs in there, two 4S packs in there, which is what we're going to do. There's some foam spacers in there to take up any extra gap. And it does use EC5 connectors. Just want you to be aware of that. So if you're going to buy batteries at the same time as this, make sure they have some EC5 connectors on there. All right, now in the center of the vehicle is actually the transmission case. There is a center differential in there. Again, all metal gears. We've got a metal drive shaft up to the front gear differential. And then the motor you can actually access on the bottom, which is pretty cool. So, you know, I did mention Working on this thing might be a little bit of a pain depending on what you got to work on, but accessing the motor is pretty easy. It's this aluminum plate right here. So you take these screws out and the motor basically just drops out. And it's attached to a aluminum motor plate that's indexed. So if you go and switch the pinion gears out, you just line the motor up with the correct indexing for the pinion and it slides right back in and it meshes with the metal gears that are in there. So again, metal gears everywhere on this, they have to be. All right, now let's see, basically all that covered by this really intricate cage work. I really love the look of the cage on this. I mean, just a lot of detail, again, throughout this whole vehicle. Let's see, let's talk about the speed controller. It is a 160 amp dynamite speed controller. It runs up to 8S, and the wires coming out of this thing are just massive, huge capacitors on here, big cooling fan, huge aluminum heatsink on there. So I think that is going to be pretty durable and handle the power. And then right behind the speed controller is actually the receiver. It's kind of between the speed controller and this faux radiator that's out back. So again, we got some more scale details with a molded radiator in the back. That is super cool looking. But the receiver is a Spectrum SRS 6000 AVC receiver. So that means it has active vehicle control, and that is, you know, basically like an onboard gyro. So that you have the assist if you want to, and you could totally tune that. If you want to dial that out, if you want to just have a full driving experience, you can do that. But I have to imagine on a vehicle this size, that will help keep things under control. So that's tucked away back there. And now let's move a little bit farther to the back. And let me see. So it's got an active link rear suspension. We've got these huge aluminum tie rods out back, lower composite plastic arms, and there is a sway bar to help keep things under control. And then what's really, really cool in my book is we've got these limiting straps that you could go and adjust the down travel on them. Pretty neat looking setup. You don't see that often in a kit. And I like that Losi fitted those to this vehicle. So the shocks, just like the front, aluminum body. We've got threaded collars on there, and basically just a replica of the front. And again, just like the front, they feel really good too. Nice and smooth. The drive shaft coming from the center differential is plastic. And it's what's pretty interesting is it says warning hot. I have to imagine it gets hot back there with all the power going through it. So just be careful of that when you're picking up the vehicle and checking things out. It does have the steel yokes on the end, so that's really cool to see. And then we've got this huge just rear axle, solid rear axle with a gear differential in it. And that spans out to faux disc brakes, just like we saw in the front. And what's pretty neat is over here, I have these little pieces that I saw in the box. These are actually toe pieces, so you could go and swap out the end caps of the axle to get a little bit more toe in the rear of the vehicle if you want that. So I thought that was a pretty neat tuning option that Losi included in there. And I think that really wraps up everything, all the details of this vehicle. The on-off switch is back here. Here's that spare tire mount. There's the rear LED light bar on it. And just a very cool setup overall. I love the robust parts that they've used here. And it looks like Losi just thought of every performance detail and fitted it to this rig. All right, now with that out of the way, I just want to talk to you really quickly about some of the stuff that's included with the kit. So we've got the DX2E radio system, kind of a basic Spectrum radio system, but it is expandable. You can put their speedometer on there, or they have their dashboard adapter on there. So if you want to do some telemetry stuff, you could do that. And there's actually these little bullet plugs here that allow you to do some of that telemetry stuff. They also give you a bind plug for the receiver and then a little bag of tools. We've got the 17 millimeter wrench, looks like a turnbuckle wrench. And then finally here, the paperwork. So here's a Spectrum telemetry module items I told you about. We've got the instruction manual and of course some decals so you can go show your Losi pride a bit more on the body shell. But that's really it, guys. I am gonna go charge up some batteries. I have a lot of battery charging to do because I wanna run this thing a lot for the test, get a lot of cool action footage and stuff, and definitely get you my thoughts on the performance of it. So I'm gonna go button this thing back up and head out to one of my favorite test spots, and we're gonna see this thing fly. We'll be right back. What a beast! There was just dirt flying, rocks flying, the buggy was flying. The Losi Super Rock Rey knows how to deliver a lot of action. This thing was so much fun to drive. I took it over to one of my usual test locations, Wolcott Hobby and Airsoft in Wolcott, Connecticut. Got a great little field out back that they use for airsoft, and sometimes they ride dirt bikes out there. But the sand and dirt of the field, along with some berms and just jumps and stuff like that, makes it the perfect test spot to drive this. And I took full advantage of the terrain. And, you know, this thing is just so much fun. I don't even know where to start with it, but let me just, you know, walk you through my experience with it. So I started off on 6S. I have a bunch of 6S packs from my pro boats, and so I had a lot of them with the EC5 connector, and so I started off by running it on just 6S, and it is a lot of fun on 6S. I know there's some vehicles out there that you can run on 6S, and they also run on 8S, and you get the full experience with 8S, and that's the only way to go, but this is actually a lot of fun on 6S. I will say that it carves through the berms really cool, you know, just dirt flying off. You know, most of the time, dirt was just roosting off all the tires on this. And but it's just really cool to just, you know, whip through corners and just watch the dirt fly off. And because, you know, it was really loamy dirt, this thing actually caught an edge a lot. The tires with this kind of sharp edge to it just dug into the dirt, and it did flip over on its lid a lot. The steering servo itself is a little on the sluggish side, but it has the torque to hold the wheels for what you need to do out there. And, you know, overall, it's decent in the steering department, and especially if you're running on loamy dirt, you know, you will be able to get this thing whipped around pretty quickly. Now, onto the handling of it, watching the suspension work, very cool. It does soak up a lot of the bumps. You know, you see the rear bucking just a little bit on some of the really big bumps and stuff like that. But overall, the suspension does its job, keeps this thing pretty stable. But onto the jumping portion of it, you really have to watch how you drive it on 6S, because I think this vehicle likes a lot more power to do more things, to have more control, if that makes sense. You know, on 6S, when I would hit some of the steep jumps, it would buck the rear up and, you know, it would cause it to tumble. And, you know, I'd have to go pick it up a lot because it would always land on the roof. This thing always lands on the roof. So you might have to do some walking when driving this thing. But with the jumps with a nice gradual, you know, incline to the ramp, this thing does fly pretty level, a little on the nose downside, but at least it lands on all four wheels and it's controllable when you're doing that. And overall, again, just a fun experience on 6S. You could see the AVC working a bit, trying to keep this thing under control. So, you know, overall, it does a very good job. Now on to 8S. This thing is a complete and different monster. Just the power of it is insane. The roost coming off of the tires, you know, the dirt just flying off of it. So cool. Again, just, you know, I got covered a bunch of times with dirt, just kind of ripping by and cutting the wheel, and just dirt would just fly off, just cover me. But, you know, that's part of the experience. It really starts to build up the adrenaline when you're driving it, and you get a little shaky because it's just so much fun. It's so cool to see how much power this has. You know, going through the corners again, you know, with a bit more power, you know, that momentum going into the corner, I did roll it. So you just have to, you know, be aware of how it handles, and, you know, maybe just limit your steering inputs. Don't carve too tight of a corner and you'd be fine with that. Handling, it was actually, I think it was a bit better handling wise on 8S. I could see the AVC working a lot more. When the vehicle was bucking up in the air over some of the bumps and stuff, you could see the wheels turning and you could see the AVC in action, keeping this thing under control. So that certainly helped out. Onto the jumping side of it, you know, much like the 6S, if you hit that steep incline of a ramp type of jump, it will buck up the rear. But with 8S, you have a better chance of pulling out of a nosedive. Just keep the throttle pegged and it will pull itself out of a nosedive. You know, if it does crash, the crashes are spectacular. There's a lot of tire on this, so basically it's just bouncing off a tire. And I don't think, you know, much is really happening to the buggy itself. It's just tires hitting. So that's absorbing a lot of the impact of it. And this thing is just covered in mud. It took a lot of abuse. I usually kind of, you know, take it easy on my first runs, but I went a little bit farther with this one and just put it through the paces, and it took a lot of abuse. And nothing happened until I was running on the 8S packs, and, you know, towards the end of the day, I actually broke a upper tie rod on it. So there was a bit of a durability issue, but, you know, I did launch this thing off of one of the big jumps and came down in a really awkward way, and, you know, I saw it snap, and I was, oh, man, I'm done for the day. But it was a lot of fun. It definitely gave me a great driving experience throughout the entire test day, and, you know, it's tough. I was hitting huge rocks with this. There's actually a chunk of plastic missing out of the front arm here. It was hitting just a lot of rocks, so it is a durable machine. It is a lot of fun, and if you're looking for something high-powered that just will go anywhere and just toss a ton of dirt, the Losi Super Rock Rey may be the vehicle you want to check out.